In this example, we want to consider the parametric curve r of t equals t squared over 2, t to the 4th over the square root of 8, t to the 6th over 6. All in all, we would like to find the equation of the oscillating plane at r of 1, or in other words, when the parameter t equals 1. In order to get to the osculating plane, we're going to need several pieces of information. So in particular, we'll need the velocity vector, r prime of t, we'll need the speed, the length of that velocity vector. We're going to need the tangent vector, the normal vector, we'll cross those to get the binormal vector because that's the vector which is perpendicular to this plane. So there are gonna be a lot of steps in this computation, but what I would like to do is try to do this computation as efficiently as possible. Meaning whenever I can, I'm going to use the fact that at the point we're interested in, t equals 1. So when I can, I'm going to plug 1 in for the parameter t because that's going to make things look simpler. At other moments in the computation, I might need to do something like take a derivative. So in those moments, I need to make sure I'm still working with the parameter t. Okay, so let's start by writing down our velocity vector r prime of t. So I'll say r prime of t is going to be the derivative term by term. So that's going to be 2t over 2 or just t. And then I'll write 4t cubed over square root of 8, but let's make that look better in a minute. And then 6t over 6, which is t to the 5. Okay, so that is our velocity vector. Square root of 8 is 2 square root of 2. So this is going to be t, 4 over 2 square root of 2 is 2 over square root of 2, which is actually just square root of 2 t cubed. That looks better. So check that, but 4 divided by the square root of 8 should just be the square root of 2. All right, the next step is to compute the speed of our parametrization, which means the length of this velocity vector. So we will take the square root of the sum of each coordinate squared. That's going to look like t squared plus 2t to the 6 plus t to the 10. We're actually going to be able to simplify this quite a bit. First, let me factor t squared in front of everything. So I'll write this as the square root of t squared times, and then I'm actually going to reverse the order here. So this is going to be t to the 8 plus 2t to the 4 plus 1, like that. Now, the reason why I did that is it just looks easier to factor in this form. T squared can come in front of the square root. Notice our t values here are positive, so I can just write plain old t. I don't need absolute values or anything like that. And then this is quadratic for the expression t to the 4th. So it actually factors as t to the 4th plus 1 times t to the 4th plus 1. It's a perfect square. So overall, the speed at any moment t is going to be t times t to the 4th plus 1. Or in other words, it's t to the 5th plus t. Okay, so there's the speed of our curve. Let's go ahead now with this information and set up the unit tangent vector t hat. T hat is going to be r prime divided by the speed. So let me just write that first. Okay. I will need to take the derivative of t in order to get to the unit normal vector, which we will also need. So let me write down the general expression in terms of t, and then we'll plug in t equals 1 to get the unit tangent vector at the moment we're actually interested in. So all that to say, let me just write equals, that in general, our unit tangent vector is going to look like all of these have a t, all of this has a t, so a t will cancel. And let me actually write the speed in front. So I'm doing a lot of algebraic decisions all at once, but whenever I can have a scalar in front of a vector, I typically prefer that. And I'll explain why in the moment, the calculation where I use that. So I'm going to write 1 over t to the 4th plus 1 times t, or sorry, 1. Maybe I'm doing too much simplification at the same time. I'll take a moment to check my work in just a second. Okay, so my first coordinate would be 1 over t to the 4th plus 1. Which is t over t to the 5th plus t. So I reduced every term here by a factor of t. And then t squared, and then t to the 4th. Okay, I think this is right. Looks good. Let's go ahead now and state what the unit tangent is when t equals 1. So we have t of 1 is going to be a half times 1 square root of 2, 1. You can check that this is unit length by construction. If I square all of these terms and add it together, I get 1 plus 2 plus 1, that's 4. Take the square root of that, that's 2. Multiply by the leading scalar, this leading positive scalar right here, 2 times 1 over 2 is 1. So this is a unit length vector, which it should be, because when we wrote this down, we said that, you know, as long as the speed is not 0, this is going to give us a unit length vector, which is tangent to our curve. This is one of the vectors that we will need in order to ultimately get to the osculating plane. But before we do that, we also need to get the n vector, the normal vector. So let me write t hat of t. I'm going to do this in general, but I'm not going to stress too much about simplification, because as soon as I've gotten the form of n hat, I'm going to plug in t equals 1. We don't need to take this any further than n of 1. So what I need to do is differentiate this and then plug in t equals 1. I'm actually not going to do that all at the same time. I'm going to do that one at a time. The reason why I like having a scalar in front is because, and here it might not make a big difference, but I like having product rule of just what look like two terms. So derivative of this times this vector, done, plus this times derivative of this vector. I think it's often cleaner than when you have more complicated coordinates and you have to do three derivatives. I just think it's often nicer. So let me just differentiate this, keep that the same way. That's going to be negative 1 t to the 4th plus 1 to the negative 2 times 4 t cubed. So that's chain rule. So I treated this as t to the 4th plus 1 to the negative 1 power. That drops down. Power rule, chain rule. That gave us the derivative of that leading scalar. Now just keep this vector the way it is. This is the first part of the product rule. Now keep the scalar the way it is and differentiate each coordinate. So we'll get 0, 2 square root of 2t, 4t cubed, like that. All right. Your dream is that t equals 0 and most of this would wipe out. That's not what we have in this problem. We have t equals 1, which is a little bit less computationally friendly. But even so, there is a remark worth making here, which is that I only need n of 1, so don't waste any time trying to clean this up, like trying to figure out if any terms can be combined or anything like that, because you're going to plug in a number and get out numbers, and those are just going to be easier to work with than this kind of general expression in terms of t. So let me go straight to the unit normal vector when t equals 1. This is going to be 4, so I'll write negative 4. This is going to be 1 over 2 squared. So negative 4 times 1 fourth, that's really nice. And then this vector is going to be 1 square root of 2, 1. I mean, 1 is not too bad to plug in. It's just not quite as nice as 0. And then plus 1 half, 0, 2 square root of 2, 4. Like that. Okay, I think I can combine these into one expression. I hope I don't run out of room here at the bottom. Let me see, I have a little bit more room if I slide it over to the right slightly. So this is going to be negative 1 times 1 plus 0. So the first coordinate is negative 1. The second coordinate is going to be negative square root of 2 plus square root of 2, because the 1 half cancels with that 2. So negative square root of 2 plus square root of 2 is 0. And then the last coordinate is going to be, this doesn't look like it's going to be right. Negative 1 plus 2 is 1. I made a mistake here. Let me fix it. Let me explain what my mistake was. I differentiated t, and I called that n, but actually I should just call it t prime. So this is t prime, this is t prime. I was like, this is not working out to be a unit length vector. So in fact, happily, accidentally did it correctly, and that you want to compute t prime in general, don't simplify, plug in t equals 1 to get the nicest form of this vector, and then just make this unit length and you'll get your unit normal vector. So my unit normal vector when t equals 1 is going to be this divided by its n length. So that's negative 1 over the square root of 2, 0, 1 over the square root of 2. Okay. So when you compute these quantities, try to make this into a teaching moment. When you compute these quantities, your t, n, and b should all be unit length. So if they aren't, check yourself. I saw that this was not unit length, but then I remembered, oh, right, I've just done the derivative. I haven't made it unit length yet. Then also TN and B should be perpendicular to each other. If I take the dot product of these two vectors, let me just look at the coordinates here. I get negative 1 over the square root of 2 plus 0 plus 1 over the square root of 2. So we get 0 times a half, so 0. Okay, I've got T and N. I need B at the moment T equals 1. There's no reason to compute B of T working with some general T expressions. We just want B of 1, which is T at 1 cross N at 1. I've got those two vectors, so let me just go ahead and take the cross product. I'm actually going to factor out a scalar, so I'm going to write 1 half times 1 over the square root of 2. Pull those scalars out front, and then I'm going to do the cross product with this style, where I have 1 square root of 2, 1. And then I have negative 1, 0, 1. Where I'm saying that's my vector I'm going to put in place of n because I pulled the 1 over square root of 2 in front. So this is going to be 1 over 2 square root of 2. Cross these, we get square root of 2. Negative 1 minus 1 is negative 2. And 0 minus negative square root of 2 is square root of 2. Okay, surely this can simplify. If I divide into everything by square root of 2 first, I'm gonna make this look a little nicer. Well, let's do 1 over 2. So you know what? I'm just gonna distribute this scalar all at once. So the square root of 2s will cancel in the first coordinate, and I'm left with 1 half. The 2s will cancel in the second coordinate, and I'll be left with 1 over the square root of 2. And then the square root of 2s cancel in the third coordinate, and I'm left with a half again. Okay, check the length of this to make sure our computation seems right. 1/4 plus a half plus a fourth is 1. So the length of this is going to be unit length. Make this look nicer, negative 1 over the square root of 2. And then it should also be perpendicular to each of the vectors we crossed it with. So 1 half plus 1 half is 1 minus 1. Okay, so that checks out. And then here, this term and this term are the same, but differ by a sign. So yes, the dot product is 0 with both t and n when t equals 1. It feels like I'm almost out of room, but actually at this point we're done because this is the orthogonal vector to our curve. So the plane is going to be this vector dot, I'm going to write it in vector parametric form or vector form. It's this orthogonal vector dot the expression xyz representing the coordinates of any point on this osculating plane minus r of 1 itself. That's just a point that we know is on our curve and therefore is on our plane. This dot product must be 0 in this vector form. So you want to dot this vector with just the expression xyz minus r of 1, which is 1 half, 1 over the square root of 8, 1 over 6. If it were me and this was on paper, I would just leave it in that form. Otherwise, you could expand it to put it in general form. But since at this point, I think we've done the heart of the problem, which was to compute the velocity vector, the speed, the unit tangent, the unit normal, the unit binormal, and then just state at the end the osculating plane, I think I will wrap this up here.